So this is your dream, yeah?
It is.
All right, well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
So far, so good.
Going.
Well done so far.
Good luck.
Put a spell on you.
talented.
I thought he did great. I think he's amazing. I love him.
So, how did you meet?
On a group holiday. And then when I got there, Al was there. He started to send me some card tricks. Phone, that's all right, isn't it? And there you go. And now he's, like, totally changed my life.
Aww.
This is what I do.
I love it.
Kat?
Yes, that's me.
The sage is yours.
Thank you. Before I start, do you mind if I just...
No, girl, you
take this off. It's not that kind of act, but it's just a little bit, just a little bit warm.
Yes! Yes!
I'm feeling much better now, thanks. So I'm a magician, and I'm going to demonstrate for you a set of skills that have taken me a lifetime to learn. Simon, I'm going to leave that there. I've heard that you like a beer, so feel free to take a swig. David.
Hi.
Hello. I am going to get you to choose a book. Okay?
A book.
Now, if I said name any book...
Oh, come on.
Let's be honest, you'd probably just choose your own.
I would,
and
yeah.
Why wouldn't you? Bit of advertising. We'd all do it, wouldn't we? So, I've got 20 books with me today.
Okay, so one of those books.
They are all different, they are all wrapped, and they're all in a random order. Can you just give me a number between 1 and 20?
7.
Number 7. Good choice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, before you open it, if you'd have chosen the one before it, you would have picked One Day. Ooh. And if you'd have chosen the one after it, you'd have picked Matt Lucas. He's a funny guy, isn't he?
He was always the funny one.
Thank you. Before you open it, using my memory skills, I can tell you that the book that you've chosen is The Lord of the Rings. Can you rip it open and take a look and show everybody?
No, it's The Girl on the Train.
What? That is a little bit embarrassing. David, I totally deserve this.
I love that you buzzed yourself.
Alicia,
yes.
I have got a bag of CDs here.
Okay.
That my mum got me from the market, you know,
right.
Look after the pennies.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff like The Jam, The Hoosiers, Beautiful South.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna pop them in there, I'm gonna give the bag a little shake. I would like you to reach inside, take one out, hold it towards you, don't show me what it is.
Okay.
Perfect, it's okay, don't show me.
Okay.
Amanda.
Yes.
My mum's been busy at the market. I've got DVDs this time. I love a bargain. I've got Dexter, The Crown, Gavin and Stacey. Can you just reach inside, take one out, take a look at it, don't show me. I've hurt my eyes. Okay. Now, using my mind reading skills, I want you to think of the CD. I want you to think of the DVD. Are you ready? Oh, I've got it. Mr. Brightside, Peaky Blinders.
Absolutely not.
No. What?
Really?
Really.
What have you chosen?
I Bet You Look Good on the Dance Floor, Arctic Monkeys.
And what have you got?
I love this one, Killing Eve.
Killing It, that is a good
love
one, isn't
Killing
it?
Killing Eve.
But, I mean, I was not even close.
No.
Simon, there is one puzzle left. I am going to save you the job, don't you worry. That's a bit weird. But I can see why it's not working. There is a piece of paper wedged underneath it. Can you reach round, take it out, and take a look at it?
Yeah. So open it.
Open it up.
It says, look at the screen.
Everybody, look at the screen. This is filmed earlier today. This is you guys arriving. Now, if you look at the poster, you all had a completely free choice. The title of the show is The Girl on the Hull Train. The Girl on the Train is what David chose. The tagline is Have a Killing Evening. Killing Eve, that is what Amanda chose.
Yes!
And out of all the songs, the song that I am listening to on my phone is The Arctic Monkeys, I Bet You Look Good on the Dance Floor.
Nice.
And that, my friend, is a miracle.
What?
But that's not it.
What?
Just in case you think I've got a tech whiz backstage that has just knocked that up, which, ridiculous, that didn't happen. That beer has been sitting there the full time.
Yeah, I had a sip.
Before I brought it out, I had some words engraved onto the glass. Can you now pick up the glass and read out loud what it says?
Killing Eve, girl on the train, you look good on the dance floor.
Thank you. And that, my friend, is a miracle. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Wow. Yes.
Thank you. I feel like I want to die.
That was incredible.
Thank you.
It was superb. And I like that you're just completely you. It was brilliant from start to finish. Very, very original.
Yeah. Thank you.
Very enjoyable.
Like David said, you're just really normal, really cool girl, so you made the whole thing very relaxed. Yeah, I really hope you go far in the competition.
You do. It's true. Just the whole thing felt so authentic. I really enjoyed it.
Oh, thank you.
I thought you did an ace job. It was brilliant.
Thanks.
For me, the end of the magic act is when you're like, what? And that's what we all did. Mm. And that's why, out of the two, you were by far the best. David?
I'm saying yes.
Oh, thank you.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Definite yes from me.
Oh, thank you.
Kat, you got four yeses.
Yeah! Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
I she's just a cool girl. She's the sort of girl I'd like to go for a drink with.
Well, well done. You bought through. Thrilled for you.
A great night for the Hudsons.
Yeah.
You can go and have a beer now, Kat.
Yeah. Go on.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Hello. And who are you?
I'm Chloe Crawford.
And where are you from, Chloe?
I'm originally from Portsmouth and now I live in Vegas.
Oh, really?
Ooh.
Okay, and what are you doing in Vegas?
I'm a magician's assistant.
And now you want to be the magician?
Yeah, that's why I came back here.
Are you nervous?
I wasn't, and now I really, really am.
Well, listen, I hope this goes well, Chloe.
You too.
Good luck.
Thank you. Simon, this one's for you.
Best of luck.
Thank you. Can I come down and join you?
You can.
Today I'm going to show you something of my two favourite things, magic and reading, using my three favourite books. My first favourite author is Colin Davis, Mathemagical. Amanda, could you look through the book and see if each page is different?
Yes, darling.
My second favourite author is Enid Blyton, The Magical Faraway Tree. Alicia, could you look through the book and see if each page is different?
OK.
My third favourite author is David Wyams, The Midnight Gang. David, could you look through the book and see if each page is different?
It would be a pleasure.
Yes. While still doing that, Simon, could you pick up my box and put it on the floor for me, please?
Where?
Over there.
She's very bossy.
Down here?
Yeah.
I can't lift it.
David, do you want to go and help
I
him?
Literally can't lift it.
We're trying together.
Go on.
To me, to you.
To me, to you.
It won't lift.
Oh, wait one minute. Could you sit back down for me, please?
All right, go sit down. Go sit down.
No, you as well.
Do as you're told.
Okay. Right, I'm back.
What happened?
Simon, I want to show you a card trick, but it's a card trick
right now. Hang on, I'm still a bit scared after that. Give me 5 seconds. OK.
As you can see, all the cards are different.
Yeah, I can.
I'm going to turn them face down, and I want you to touch the back of any card.
All right. That one. Thank you.
I want you to look at your card, remembering don't let anyone else see.
I won't. OK.
Now, Simon, you're the boss. I want you to pick any book, either Amanda, Alicia or David's.
Alicia's, please.
Alicia's book has about 600 pages. Could you name a number between 1 and 600?
It's 77.
Alicia, could you turn your book to page 77 yes. for me, please? And check if all the words are different.
Yes, all the words are different.
Now, could you pick any word and tell us what it is?
Kettle.
Kettle. Remember, Sam, you could have picked any book, and Alicia, you could have chosen any word, but you chose kettle.
Yes.
See this blackboard? Before the show tonight, I wrote a word on the board. Watch.
No way.
No way.
What was your card?
It's the Four of Diamonds. Want to tell us who you are, please?
Mandy Mudin.
And where are you from?
London.
All right. Mandy, how old are you?
Let's just say I've seen a few summers and leave right. it there, Simon.
That's a good answer. We've all seen a few summers, Mandy. Is this what you do full time?
Yeah, I'm a bit of a performer.
Have you nearly had that opportunity where you had that break?
To be quite honest, not really, because my family don't even really know who I am, so no, no.
They don't know who you are?
No, they're always confused when I come home, but, you know. Keep trying, you never know.
All right, well, look, good luck.
Thank you very much.
It's just right up my street.
It's fun.
OK, now, I'm going to show you something that is a little bit extraordinary, OK? Whatever I write or draw on this pad becomes a reality. I was hoping I'd be a bit older when the melons dropped. Now, I'm completely psychiatric, psychotic, and some people do actually call me a witch. And, David, I'm being very drawn to you. Can you feel me stroking your aura? You will in a minute. Now, David, I'm going to try and read your mind. I want you to think of somebody, David, that you're very, very attracted to. Who is it, David, that you're very, very attracted to?
Simon!
That's interesting. Now, Alicia, I'm being drawn to you, and I want you to think of something you like to do most days. All right, here we go. All right, what are you thinking of?
Food.
She's brilliant, this girl.
I love her.
Right, Simon, because it's you, dear, I want you to think of a number between 1 and 5,000. Make it really hard for me, all right? Here we go, Simon. Are you thinking? OK, this'll be it. What number were you thinking of?
777.
That is uncanny. Amanda,
Yeah?
Would you be so kind as to join me on stage?
Oh, that'd be amazing.
Amanda, doesn't she look gorgeous? To sit on that stool. Now, Amanda, just touch any card you like. Yes, touch any card. Take it out. Look at it. Okay, I'm going to make a prediction of what it is. Show everybody and remember it. Okay. Just to say, David, you're very attracted to Simon, and I don't blame you with that lovely jawline. Alicia, you like food?
What?
And your number was 777. Was that right, Simon?
Yes.
But that says 770.
Oh, maybe I've got that one wrong, but let's move on. OK. Sometimes witches can't be perfect. Now, Amanda, what was the card?
It was the Four of Spades.
The Four of... Was it?
Yes.
Not the three?
No, it was a four.
So we're a spade missing then, everybody. OK, well, look, here it is.
I think she was really good.